to be focused. All right, Ustad, we're ready for you if you're ready for us.
Okay. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So we begin this fantastic Friday by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending our love and salams upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is our final Friday before the beautiful month of Ramadan begins. And I know that Ms. Afifa, your teachers, have been introducing to you as this month of Ramadan is about to begin, what we like to call at AFA, the Ss of Ramadan. Because if you look, there's a lot of things that we do in the month of Ramadan that actually begin with the letter S in English. And I wanted to, as an introduction to the month of Ramadan today, since it's coming, inshallah, Monday night, and the first day of fasting is set to be Tuesday next week, inshallah, to talk about one of those S's. And that sets for us a foundation for the month of Ramadan. So the month of Ramadan is, of course, a month of Sawm, a month of Sawm, or another word you may hear is Siyam. And both of those words begin with an S in English, and they mean fasting. And in Arabic, that word Sawm is a really cool word. When I first learned about it, whenever you're learning about a word, you can look to how it is used to see, well, what are some lessons I can learn from the word itself? So Ramadan, or excuse me, Sawm means the action of fasting. But interestingly, in Arabic, you can say something, for example, called Sama al-ma. Sama al-ma. And I think a lot of you know what the word ma means, or maya, right? Ma is water. So if you translate Sama al-ma as we would normally for us, that would mean the water is fasting. But of course, water doesn't fast. Water can't fast. So what does it mean when it says, when the Arabs would say Sama al-ma? It means the water was still. The water was calm, right? So we know if you ever throw a rock in the water and you see the ripples that come from the water, when those ripples finish, you would say at that point, Sama al-ma, the water became still. It had Sakina, another one of our S's in the month of Ramadan. It became calm. All right. And in Ramadan, when we slow down as we fast, we think about things a little bit more because we're, you know, being extra careful in the month of Ramadan with what we, when we eat, how we eat, what we say, we feel a sense of calm and sakina in us. Now, another thing the Arabs would say is they would say, Samat ash-shams. Samat ash-shams, the same word. So it doesn't mean, you all know what shams is. Shams is the sun. It doesn't mean the sun is fasting, right? That's silly. It means the sun was still. Now, if you've ever observed the sun, right, the sun starts in the morning time at the horizon, and then it moves throughout the day. The sun is always moving, right? But there is a point where you could say the sun became still, and that is right at the top, what we call in English the zenith, the top. Right? When it's basically the noon part of the day, when the sun goes all the way, what looks like the top of the sky. And then after that, it starts to come back down and it's moving. So one of the benefits we take from this is that in Ramadan, we are like that sun. When we fast, we get to the highest point. We get to our highest connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We work on ourselves, we renew ourselves to be the best, the utmost we can be. And so when we fast in Ramadan, a month of Sawm, we feel that sakina, we feel that calmness, and it helps us reach our heights, to be the best that we can be. And in this month of Ramadan, you know, the action of Sawm, this action of fasting, occurs when we leave off of things. We're emptying ourselves, right? We're not going to have water for a certain time. We're not going to have food for a certain time. We're not going to, you know, shout and say bad things during that time or any time, but especially during that time. And I came across a really amazing example by one of our scholars of the past, Maulana Jalaluddin Rumi, rahimahullah. And he said, okay, to be like a lute. Okay, a lute. In the month of Ramadan, he said, be like a lute. A lute is a, if you think of a guitar, okay, I know some of you have a guitar and you play a guitar, right? A lute is the old school version of a guitar, basically. In Arabic, al-ud. And you can see that it has strings, and then it has this, it has the shape of it, which is hollow on the inside. Okay, so it's empty on the inside, and the sound travels through the cavity, and it comes out. So Maulana Rumi says about the lute, he says, there is an unseen sweetness in the stomach's emptiness. We are lutes. Each of us is like a lute. When the sound box is filled, no music can come forth. So what he's saying is, in Ramadan, when we fast and we empty ourselves of food and drink, right, we become like a lute. When the lute is empty on the inside, you can hear the music. But if it's stuffed on the inside, the sound is not going to travel. So you're not going to get any music coming forth. So he says, when the brain and the belly are burning from fasting, you know when you fast and you feel that pain sometimes? Every moment a new song rises out of the fire. When you're empty and you fast, Allah gives you those moments where you rise up, right? Like the sun rises into the sky. And so Maulana Rumi teaches us that being empty gives us a chance to be our best, to be at the best we can be, the best Muslim we can be. And Ramadan helps us to renew ourselves in this month. And so to close, right, Ramadan is a month of Sawm. It's a month of fasting. Fasting helps us to be calm, to be empty, to feel Sakina, to reach the heights that we can reach with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it may be a little tough, right, when we fast, but as Maulana Rumi says, that allows you to become new every month. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us the same thing. He said in a famous hadith, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaba." Whoever fasts the month of Ramadan faithfully, meaning they try their best, and they seek Allah. They do it because Allah tells them to. They do it because they want to please Allah and they love Allah and they want the reward from Allah. غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. He will be forgiven of his past mistakes and errors. So you empty out the bad. You empty out whatever mistakes you made before Ramadan. Allah will forgive you of those and make you new. So you have a new song. You have a new renewed spirit with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this month of Sawm, right, let's practice on finding those moments where we feel that Sakina. And when we, you know, practice fasting or doing whatever little fasting we're doing, we use it to remember Allah and reach that height with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah, we'll talk more about the other S's of Ramadan, and inshallah, we'll explore this beautiful month together in the coming Musalla times and the coming Jummas. So jazakallahu khairan.
Alhamdulillah. Thank you, Ustadh Ismail, for that great reminder, especially before Ramadan comes. And I think also, Ustadh, we've been talking about Sawm in some ways also means to keep yourself from doing something.
Yeah, right? Absolutely. So
and the stillness, part of the stillness that you're talking about, also helps you to not to do something. Would that That's be right. a way to say it?
Yeah, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he even said, "As-sawmu junnah," right? Fasting, sawm is a shield, right? When you put up that barrier, it protects you. It gives you that feeling calm. You feel safe and secure. And so, fasting helps you to prevent from doing something that may disturb that sakina that you have. So yeah, I think that's a really important aspect about it too.
So we could even be fasting from doing something other than not eating, right? We could
Yeah,
be fasting
absolutely.
keeping
Not
ourselves.
just from food or from drink, but from, you know, we make our focus on Allah from, you know, when we get pushed by our siblings or our friends, we say, okay, it's Ramadan. I'm gonna push that aside. I'm gonna protect myself from saying something that I might not like later on.
Or if I complain a lot, I'll try to stop from complaining or keep away from or try to fast from doing that. Or if I'm playing video games too much, I'll try to fast from doing video games, maybe
Exactly.
taking up too much time. So
Yeah.
that's a great way to use it for a lot of things. Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. Barakallahu fiqh. Okay, so we are now ready to did we skip the other? Oh no, we have the other now. So, Ryan, are you here?